Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So in this video we will be learning about natural color system. So natural color system is nothing but a human based perception color model. Okay, it is based on human perception rather than colors derived from mixing. So in my colors wheels video we saw that there are primary colors, and adding primary colors we get secondary colors, and adding further these two we get tertiary colors. Okay, so natural color system does not depend on this mixing, rather it is based on human perceptions of a color. Okay, so natural color system is a three-dimensional model in which there is an orbit considering of four primary hues, that is red, blue, green and yellow, and white and black are located at its vertical points. Okay, so these six colors are known as elementary colors, and red, blue, green, yellow are known as unique hues or unique colors. Okay, so now considering this orbit of red, blue, green and yellow, let's look at this plan. Okay, now these are four elementary colors, red, blue, green and yellow, right? So considering this red and yellow quadrant, okay, now there is yellow and there is red, and there are mixture of colors that I derived from yellow and red. So consider Y30R. Okay, Y30R is nothing but 70% of yellow color and 30% of red color. Okay, that stands for Y30R. Similarly for Y70R, it's 30% of yellow and 70% of red. As red keeps on increasing, it tends towards the red circle. Okay, similarly now let's see about R30B. R30B is nothing but 70% of red and 30% of blue, right? So now as you saw the red, blue, green, yellow orbit, you might have noticed that red and green cannot be paired because they are in the opposite directions. Similarly, blue and yellow cannot be paired because they are in opposite directions. And in vertical points, there is white and black, right? So consider this Y90R for right now, okay? So this is a Y90R hue triangle. So this triangle, which consists of colors of red percepted, are known as U triangle. Okay, U triangle. So each color has its own U triangle. For example, this U triangle belongs to Y90R. So similarly, there will be a U triangle for R10B, R20B, R30B individually. Okay, so there is a certain process of nomenclature of a color of natural color system. So we will learn about that right now. So natural color system are derived from human perceptions, we saw earlier. So these colors are derived in three values. Those values are, first one is specifying degree of blackness denoted by S. So S is nothing but amount of blackness in a color. Okay, this value is represented by S. Second one is chromaticness. Chromaticness, chroma or saturation of a color, is how pure the color is, right? So this value is denoted by C. The third one is the hue itself. So hue can be individual or may be paired with one another. For example, Y can be individual or Y can be paired with yellow red or yellow green. Remember, Y cannot be paired with blue because they are in the opposite directions of the orbit, right? Similarly, red cannot be paired with green because they are in the opposite directions. So blackness plus chromaticness, the first two properties together are known as nuance of a color, right? So blackness and chromaticness, that is nuance, can be equal to 100 or it will be less than 100, right? So right now consider, for example, S plus C value gives me as 60, right? So whatever the remaining percentage is, so 40% is remaining, so this indicates whiteness of a color. right? For example, consider this nomenclature NCS. Each and every color stated in the natural color system begins with the NCS S2030Y90R. Now remember, this S is denoted for colors which are derived in 1950s NCS color system, right? So the latest color system need not have this letter. If the color system is derived in 1950, then it will have an S, okay? So going forward, 2030Y90R. You know that Y90R is nothing but the U triangle, and the first two digits indicates brightness of a color, that is S value, and the second two digits 2030 indicates chromaticness of a color. So this is blackness of a color, this is chromaticness of a color. So S plus C value here gives me 50%. So the remaining 50% indicates the whiteness of a color, right? So Y90R is nothing but 10% of yellow and 90% of red color. So let's see how to guess these colors, okay? See, now we are at 2030Y90R, right? So Y90R is nothing but this U triangle. See, this axis indicates S, which means there is the 20th value, okay? Which means this row is 20s, okay? And 2030, this is the chromaticness, which means 30. Where these two line indicates, intersects, this is the color, right? Which means this is the color 2030Y90R. Please remember that this axis denotes blackness and this axis denotes chromaticness. So where these two lines intersect, we get the color. And by default, it is Y90R's U page. Each and every color has its own U page, which means R60B has its own U page, R20B has its own U page, like that. So now we saw the nomenclature for colors, right? Considering for achromatic colors, there is a denotation of N at the end, okay? That's for denoting achromatic colors. We add N at the end. See, S is added for colors derived in 1950s natural color system, and N is added for achromatic colors. For example, NCS S9000N is nothing but this color. This color is not a pure black. It's a light mixture of gray. So, you have seen the nomenclature of natural color system. Okay, there are two more terms which are considered. These are not very important terms, but also let's learn about this. Fourth one is saturation and fifth one is lightness. First three we saw is blackness of a color, chromaticness of a color, hue of a color. Similarly, fourth and fifth is nothing but saturation. You might say that chromaticness and saturation is the same thing. Yes, it's the same thing, but as I told you, these two are not so important values, right? And this is lightness of a color. So saturation refers to relationship between chromaticness and whiteness regardless of the hue, which means for this saturation calculation, you need not consider hue. You just have to consider chromaticness and whiteness. Remember, whiteness is obtained by S plus C value, which is nuance. Whatever the remaining value of S plus C, it is considered as whiteness of a color. So also we have this formula, M is equal to C upon C plus W, where C stands for chromaticness and W stands for whiteness. Okay? And for lightness, that is black or white rather than U. For color, which is achromatic, there is V is equal to 0 for pure black color, V is equal to 1 for pure white color. Okay, for finding in the lightness of the color, the formula is V is equal to 100 minus S upon 100. This S stands for blackness of a color. Okay, so as we saw the natural color system, Natural color system is not an important concept considering for GATE, okay? You need not study about natural color system. If you have time at the later end, you might watch this video and get some knowledge rather than studying it for or giving some extra time for natural color system, okay? So hope you like my video very much. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel.